Hello children, we start with the new chapter comparing quantities, and in part 1, which is the introduction of the chapter, we will be doing ratio and percentage. Children, you have already learned about these topics under this chapter, same heading, comparing quantities in standard 7. So when we start with ratio and percentage, let us just revise what ratio means and what percentage means. So let's begin. What is ratio? Ratio means comparing two quantities. Now these two quantities also should have the same units. You are comparing the quantities and they should have the same units. If you are comparing two fruits, you can compare. You can compare two vegetables, but you cannot compare fruits with number of boys, or you cannot compare number of boys with number of liters. The unit should be same. Now, for example, I have taken a basket has two types of fruits, 20 apples and 5 oranges. So, you have to find ratio of number of oranges to number of apples. Now, when we write down ratio, we have to see what is given first. Here, number of oranges are given first and then number of apples. So, how many number of oranges? There are 5 oranges. So, it is 5:20. How many apples? 20. Either you write this as 5:20 or 5/20 in the fraction form, which is equal to 1/4. You simplify it and you get 1:4. Always simplify wherever possible. Another question is, another thing which is asked is ratio of number of apples to number of oranges. Now here number of apples are first, so we write 20 first, and is to number of oranges, so we write 5 later on. So 20:5 or 20/5. When you simplify it, you get 4/1, which is equal to 4:1. So I hope you have understood how to write in ratio whenever you are given ratio of. Now, to compare two quantities, the only thing you have to remember is their units must be same. Whenever you find a ratio of any two quantities, their units has to be same. And after finding the ratio, ratio does not have any unit. This also you have to remember. I write 1:4. I don't write oranges or apples. I just write 1/4. Ratio does not have any unit, and ratio can be found of the quantities having same unit. Now, if suppose you say 3 meters is 5 kilometers, then what you do is you convert either meters into kilometers or you convert kilometers into meters and then find the ratio. If you are given 4 rupees is 10 paisa, then convert 4 rupees into paisa or you convert paisa into rupees. The units have to be same. That is the point which you have to take care of and remember. You cannot find ratio of the quantities having different units. That you have to remember. And another point you have to remember is ratio has no unit. Now we come to percentage. What you had learned about percentage. Percentage is derived from a Latin word per centum. You have heard the word century, isn't it? So that is centum. Per centum, and century means 100, and per centum means per 100. So percentage is derived from a Latin word per centum. Now, percentage are numerators of the fraction with denominators 100. You already know, out of 100. Per centa means out of 100. So, whatever is in the numerator, and if the denominator is 100, then it becomes the percentage. For example, in mathematics, Raju scored 80 marks out of 100. That is 80 out of 100. The denominator is 100. So the numerator becomes the percentage. Means he scored 80%. Now, in percentage, you have to learn how to convert the given value into percentage, or how to convert percentage into numerical value. Let's see. Understand this very carefully. One thing which is necessary here to convert the given value into percentage, we should know the total out of how much is the given value. See here, a basket has 20 apples and 5 oranges. Now, how to compare this quantities by percentage? That means how many percentage of apple and how many percentage of oranges are in the basket. There are two methods, and we will be using any one method. It is up to you. You can use any method, but I will be following the unitary method. So there are 5 oranges out of 25 fruits. So, because I told you before, the total number is very necessary when you want to convert the given value into percentage. So, percentage of oranges is 5 upon 25 into 4 upon 4. Why? Because percentage is always out of 100. So, I want to convert this denominator into 100. Like we used to do in LCM. You cannot multiply the denominator just. You have to also multiply the numerator with the same number. So to convert this 25 into 100, I have to multiply by 4. So the numerator also I will multiply by 4. So that gives me 20 upon 100, which is 20%. Another method, unitary method. That means out of 25 fruits, number of oranges are 5. Now, percentage is always out of 100. So, out of 100 fruits, number of oranges will be how much? You cross multiply, that is 5 into 100 upon 25. But how you will remember? You will remember the number of oranges out of total number, which is 25 into 100, which is equal to 20. So 20% are of oranges. To understand this method properly, I am giving you one more example. You have scored 72 marks out of 80 in mathematics. Maths ke exam mein tumne 80 marks mein se 72 mile hai. You have got 72 out of 80. So how many percentage of marks you have got or you have scored in maths? You have to convert this 72 marks out of 80 into percentage. So what we will do is, whatever marks scored out of total number of marks. So that is 72 out of 80. See here, 72 out of 80, and you multiply with 100. 0, 0 gets cancelled, 8 1s are and 8 9s are, and 9 into 10 is 90%. So you have scored 90% in mathematics. Come back to our unitary method. You found that 20% of oranges were there. Now, how many percentage of apple? We know that percentage means out of 100. That means total is 100 always. So, percentage of apple plus percentage of oranges is equal to 100. So, percentage of apple we don't know, but we have found out percentage of oranges, that is 20, which is equal to 100. So, percentage of apple is 100 minus 20, which is equal to 80. So, it is 20% of oranges and 80% of apple. Is it clear? I hope you have understood. If you have not, once again, whatever is asked, percentage of oranges, then this number of oranges upon total number into 100 will give you percentage. That is what you have to remember. Now, how to convert the given ratio into percentage? Let's see how to convert the ratio into percentage. Now, example we will take, convert 3:5 into percentage. Let us convert 3:5 into percentage. So I write down this ratio in the form of a fraction. So percentage is equal to 3/5 into 100. You multiply by 100. When you multiply, you get 60%. 3/5 into 100, 5 ones are and 5 twenties are and 23s are 60. So 60%. Whatever is the ratio, multiply with 100, you can convert it into percentage. But now percentage is given, and how to convert this percentage into numerical value? Again, let's take one example. In a class of total 50 students, 40% are girls. How many boys are there in the class? So there are total 50 students and 40% of them are girls. Whenever we have to convert ratio into percentage, or whenever we have to convert the given value into percentage or percentage into given value, we should always know the total number. So here it is given total number, there are 50 students and from that 40% are girls. So first we'll find number of girls and then we will find the number of boys. Number of girls is equal to 40% of 50. That means I write down it in this manner, 40% of 50, which you have already learned in your 7th standard. Now I will remove this percentage sign. That means the denominator becomes 100. So 40/100. 40% means 40/100 and into 50. So 0, 0 cancel. This is 2 20s are and 2 5s are and 5 and 5 will get cancelled. Once again, 0 and 0 will get cancelled. I can cancel this 0 and this 0. 5 1s are, 5 2s are and 2 20s are. Any way you can do the calculations, you will get the answer 20. So number of girls are 20. 40% of 50 means 20. Therefore, number of boys, total number minus the girls, which is 50 minus 20, that is equal to 30. Once again, 40% are girls, that means 40% of 50, which is total number is 50. So 40% of 50, 40% means 40/100. Instead of you write multiply into 50. Do the cancellation, you will get 20. So number of boys is equal to 50 minus 20, which is equal to 30. And that is the answer. Let's take example 1 of your textbook. It is given that a picnic is being planned in a school of a class 7. Girls are 60% of the total number. Total number is not given, but 60% of them are girls and total number of students and are 18 in number. And that means this 60% means 18. 18 girls are there total, which is 60% of the total number. The picnic site is 55 kilometers from the school. And the transport company is charging at the rate of rupees 12 per kilometer. The total cost of refreshment will be rupees 4,280. So can you tell the ratio of number of girls to the number of boys in the class? And second is the cost per head if two teachers are also going with the class. And if their stop is at a place 22 kilometers from the school, if their first stop is at a place 22 kilometers from the school, what percent of the total distance of 55 kilometers is this? So how much is this, how much percentage of distance of the total of 55 kilometers? What is the percentage of distance is left to be covered? Is it clear? Okay, so let's begin. First, let us find the ratio of number of girls to number of boys in the class. Now, to find the ratio, we need the total number first, always. So, let us find first the ratio of number of boys to number of girls. Now, total number of students are not given, so let's just find out what is the total number. And for that, let us write, let the total number of students be equal to x. Whatever is given now, we will write down afterwards. First, let us assume, because we are not given total number of students. So, let the total number of students be x. Number of girls is equal to 60% of x, because here it is, you are given. Girls are 60% of the total number of students, and total number of students are x. So, 60% of x. But you are also given that number of girls are 18. So, number of girls are 18. That means these two are same, because both are number of girls. Both represent number of girls. So, I write down, therefore, 60% of x is equal to 18. So, 60 upon 100 into x is equal to 18. I write this 60% into the form of percentage. Into x is equal to 18. So, 60x is equal to 1800. So, 60x is equal to 1800. So, therefore, x is equal to 1800 upon 60, and that is equal to 30. 0 and 0 will get cancelled. 6 ones are and 6 30s are 180. So, total number of students are 30. Now, number of boys you can easily find. Number of boys is 30 minus number of girls, which is 30 minus 18, and that is equal to 12. So, the ratio of girls to boys. See, here you are given girls to the number of boys. So, we'll write first the girls. 18 is to 12, or 18 upon 12, which is equal to, when you simplify, 6 3s are and 6 2s are, so 3 upon 2. Or you can write 3 is to 2. It is up to you. Now the second one, the cost per head. If two teachers are also going with the class. So, what is the cost? So, first we will have to find the total expense to find the cost. So, let's take the second. To find the cost per person, first the total expense, first the transportation charge. Now, transportation charge of 1 kilometer is rupees 12. So, total transportation charge will be distance both the ways. You go and you come. So, both the ways into 12. And total distance is given to be 55 kilometers. So, 55 into 2. This 2 means coming and going. And into 12 is the cost per kilometer. So, 55 into 2 is 110 into 12, which is equal to rupees 1320. Now, refreshment charges. What does refreshment charges mean? See, when you go for a picnic, your teacher also provides you some refreshment like breakfast they give you some cold drink. So, these are refreshment charges, which is rupees 4280. So, total cost will be refreshment plus transportation. So, that is rupees 4280 plus rupees 1320. That is 55600. That is the total cost. Now, total number of person, because we want to find cost per person. This is the cost of all the people who went for the picnic. So, total number of person is number of students plus two teachers, which is 30 plus 2, that is 32. So, therefore, cost per person is total cost divided by number of people. You get rupees 175. This is the cost of one person. That is rupees 175. oh, very cheap. No, when you go for picnic, it is 400 or 500 rupees. Now, third one. The distance of the place where the first stop was made was 22 kilometers. So you are asked the percentage of the total distance, which is of 55 kilometers. I always told you, when you have to convert into percentage, what you do is this out of the total. So 22 out of total kilometers is 55 into 100, and 11 twos are and 11 fives are and 5 ones are and 5 twenties are. So 20 into 2 is 40%. So this is how you convert the numerical value into percentage. This out of the total into 100. So now the exercise will become very easy for you. This was just the explanation. You understand the explanation in your classwork book. You write down the definition of ratio. You write down the definition of percentage. And you do example 1 in your classwork book. Next part, we will start with the exercise. So till then, stay home, stay safe.